Hey everybody, it's Pembroke W. Corgi, and I'm here to talk about Popeye. Well, not Popeye exactly, but more his main nemesis, or nemesi. Here's the thing, see these two guys? You think those are the same guy, don't you? But they're not. The guy here on the left is Brutus. The guy here on the right is Bluto. The most well-known of these two guys is definitely Bluto. See, there's a weird issue with these guys that I'm going to get into. We'll start with Bluto's origin. Bluto first appeared in the Thimble Theater / Popeye comic strips in 1932. He was a big-time nemesis known as Bluto the Terrible, and he only appeared in one story arc that was done by the original creator E.C. Segar. When Bluto appeared, though, it was a big deal, as his fight with Popeye literally took 2 weeks' worth of comic strips to finish. That might not sound like a lot in words, but as far as comics go, yeah, that's a big, long fight. That's literally like 14 strips, and that includes like the Sunday strips that are twice as big. That's like a Dragon Ball Z level fight there, and let me tell you, it was freaking crazy. So crazy that King Features and E.C. Segar would even put in ads in the newspapers about how big this fight was. It was a big deal. So in 1933, despite the fact that Popeye only fought Bluto once, it's kind of not too surprising that the Flesher studio that made the animated Popeye cartoons kind of looked at this guy and said, you know what, let's make him Popeye's main antagonist. Because at the time, yeah, he's the guy who gave Popeye the fight of his life, the biggest fight ever. And weirdly, because of the cartoons, Bluto became Popeye's nemesis and became his big-time enemy, despite the fact that in the comics, I would say his main antagonist was probably more the Sea Hag. But anyways, Bluto became the big villain and would go on from even after the Flesher era ended and the famous studio theatrical shorts began, Bluto continued to be Popeye's big nemesis. Occasionally they'd have other people come in, but Bluto was like the main one. Now come to the 1960s, King Features, the owners of the Popeye comic strip where everything originated from, decided to make their own Popeye cartoons for TV. And they kind of ran into a problem, or so they thought. Seemingly Paramount, the people who own the theatrical Popeye cartoons, believed that they owned the Bluto character. And for whatever reason, King Features didn't do the research to see that, well, no, Bluto first appeared in the comics, so they did. But for whatever reason, they didn't do this research and thought Paramount was right and that they couldn't use Bluto. So instead, they made this XB for the 1960s Popeye cartoon and named him Brutus. He pretty much looks like Bluto, except he's kind of fat. Really? He's also voiced by the voice actor that last played Bluto to just add to the weirdness. Actually, the weirdest thing about this is the pilot for the Popeye cartoon that King Features made, which is called Barbecue for Two, actually has a scene where Brutus is supposed to say his name. And I guess they, at the time, they didn't know what to call him, and it gets kind of censored out very weirdly and abruptly. I mean, look at this scene.
Junior! Junior! Don't call me a sissy name like that! My name is...
What the hell was that? I guess his name is... I don't know. I can only assume this is part of the fact that King Features didn't think they had the rights to Bluto and didn't know what to call him at the moment, even though he definitely looks like Brutus's design. And yeah, that kind of just happened. Granted, in all the rest of the King Features animated series, he would be named Brutus. Another interesting note about Barbecue for Two is it's the only episode of the King Features TV Popeye cartoon to have Popeye wearing his comic strip outfit, as well as Olive Oil also looking more like her comic interpretation, namely the fact that she has dot eyes like she does in the comics. Heck, Popeye even has hair in this like he does in the comics, which is weird because, you know, in the cartoons they always represent him as bald for some reason, but that's a story for another day. So yeah, King Features, for whatever reason, didn't do the proper research, thought they didn't own the name of Bluto, and named Popeye's nemesis Brutus instead, and made him fat.
Really?
Seems weird they didn't do the proper fact-checking, but this was also in the 1960s, so I guess fact-checking wasn't as easy as it is now. Having access to the internet does make fact-checking far easier now than it would in 1960s. Regardless, King Features must have figured out that they did own Bluto eventually, because when Hanna-Barbera would later make a Popeye cartoon in the late 70s and early 80s, they would go back to using the name Bluto instead of Brutus. Also, around the time that King Features were making their 60s-era TV Popeye cartoons, Brutus would also get introduced in the comics. Granted, this was after E.C. Sigar had passed away, and his assistant Bud Sagendorf was now in charge of the comics. Bud Sagendorf's depiction of Brutus is similar, but also kind of different. As far as modern day is concerned, Bluto and Brutus are both in the comics. They seem to be treated as if they are twin brothers of sorts. So with all that said, you think this is the end of the whole Bluto and Brutus thing? Well, not exactly. There is one more time that Brutus got used, and I figure it's worth mentioning. And that's in the 1982 arcade game by Nintendo. Nintendo's Popeye arcade game, for whatever reason, seems to be based on the 1960s King Features cartoon show. Because of this, Bluto is not in the game, it's instead Brutus. The Sea Hag also appears in the design that she has in the King Features cartoon show. This is further shown by the fact that Popeye is wearing his Navy outfit instead of his comic outfit, and all of the artwork on the cabinet is directly based on the designs from the 1960s cartoon show. This is really weird because the Hanna-Barbera Popeye cartoon, which used designs closer to the comic strips, actually was still airing on TV when this game was made. So why they used the 1960s Popeye designs and not the current cartoon Popeye designs from the Hanna-Barbera show, I have no earthly idea. And I haven't found any answers to this either. I can only assume that was a decision by King Features since they directly made that version. But I mean, they still have the rights to the Hanna-Barbera show, so I don't understand why that would have been a problem. Maybe it's because the theatrical shorts are honestly the most popular part of Popeye media, and since Paramount owned them, they decided to go with the King Features designs because they are closer to the theatrical designs than the Hanna-Barbera ones are, but I don't know. Or maybe the King Features Popeye cartoons were just what was airing in Japan at the time. Who's to say for certain? I don't know. I have yet to find a really good answer for this, but I do find it to be a weird anomaly. A weirder anomaly is, for as far as I know, Popeye has never worn this Navy outfit in any of the comics. Despite this, on the flyer for this arcade game, you get Popeye drawn in what is obviously the Bud Sagendorf art style wearing the Navy outfit, which just looks weird. What's also amusing is the commercials used to sell the early console versions of Popeye based on the arcade game, which is using the, again, King Features art style, actually uses the art style and outfits of the comics. It's kind of weird that this commercial based on this game isn't even using the designs of this game.
You choke, you wimp.
I ain't wimpy.
I'm much better looking.
Damn, wimpy be looking pissed. Oh, you don't have to wait till Tuesday for me to give you an insult today, my friend. So, yeah, that's the story of the whole Brutus and Bluto fiasco that happened with Popeye, and some bad copyright misinformation and not doing the proper research. So now we have two characters that look very similar. Oh well, at least they're twin brothers now, I guess. Let me know if you want to hear more random cartoon facts. I actually know more weird stuff about Popeye, like the color of his hair, or how his longest running voice actor, Jack Mercer, wasn't even a voice actor originally, he was an animator. Or the fact that Popeye wasn't even the original star of the comic strip that would spawn him. In fact, Olive Oil was originally the main protagonist of the comics, before Popeye was even created. How strange is that? So let me know if you want to hear more about that stuff. And until next time, see ya!